Here is one way in which an intelligent agent can work in a complex environment in which there are a large number of percepts and actions possible, and yet do so relatively efficiently. Suppose that these 2 to the power n percepts could be mapped into k concepts, where each of these k concepts is an equivalence class for a large number of these combinations. So 2 to the power n may be very, very large, but k is a much smaller number. So these concepts are now equivalence classes of these percepts. So now, instead of indexing my actions on the combinations of percepts, I index my actions on the equivalence classes that I'll call concepts. And this happens all the time. You go to a doctor, for example, and you may go with some signs and symptoms. And your doctor says, well, I have to decide whether I'll give you a blue liquid or a red liquid. Assume that those are the actions possible. And the actions are now indexed not on the signs and symptoms or the combinations of signs and symptoms, which are potentially very large for human beings, but a certain small number of concepts, the number of diseases, which compared to all the combinations of signs and symptoms is much smaller.
Another example of this that would come from computer programming would be that we might have a small number of different ways in which a computer program can go wrong, but a large number of different percepts that tell us what has actually gone wrong. So for example, in my percepts, I might have whether or not I received a null pointer error, whether or not I received a memory allocation error, whether or not I received a index is larger than the size of an array error. All of those are different percepts I might have, but they might map the same underlying concept of something has not yet been initialized. So I'm taking the number of things that I can actually see and mapping them to a smaller number of ways in which the program can actually go wrong. Then instead of having to map each individual percept to some number of actions, I know that if my error is that something has not been initialized, I need to find what hasn't been initialized. And there's a much smaller number of actions involved looking at each individual variable and seeing where the initialization has not taken place.
Now we understand why classification is such an often studied topic in artificial intelligence. Almost every school of artificial intelligence has studied classification extensively. If there were no concepts, we were mapping these 2 to the power n combinations of percepts into these 2 to the power m combinations of actions, then we could think of an intelligent agent as a one large giant table. The rows of that table are all the 2 to the power n combination of percepts, so there will be that many rows, and the columns are 2 to the power m actions. Given a percept, I know exactly what action to take. The table tells me that. But it's going to be a very large table. We don't know how to use it. It will be very costly to use it, and we don't know how to build such a table. What classification is doing is, it is breaking that large table into a large number of small tables. And that's the power of knowledge. When you have knowledge, you can take some complex problem and break into a large number of smaller, simpler problems.